If you had your way, what would you have changed about EDSA? Is there something that you could have, you know, could have done otherwise?
Maybe I should have taken a more visible role as an advocate of fundamental change. As it is, maybe because of my own reluctance to bask in the limelight despite reports and media accounts to the contrary, I would have been an advocate for fundamental reforms, minimum fundamental reforms, that would ride on the goodwill and the momentum and the miracle of EDSA. In fact, it has come to pass that after two EDSAs or two and a half EDSAs and the prospect of more EDSAs, I think we have always answered very highly personalized questions like, we remove Marcos, whom do we put in place? And the automatic answer was, by default, President Cory Aquino. We did it again. President Estrada, maybe for valid, legitimate reasons. No? And then whom do we put in place? What I would have wanted to ask, had I been asked, knowing what I know now, no, had I known then, I would have asked, what do we put in place? What are the systemic re-engineering projects that we must undertake so that fundamental reforms can take place? And the goodwill, not only of President Cory Aquino, but of the event itself, state of the art in revolutions, would have added value to long-term adjustments